Our state's insurer of last resort is looking to shed up to 80,000 more policies.
Citizens is now looking at seasonal residents and those with second homes. NBC2's Evan Dean found out what it could mean if you fall in that category.
The water line was about here.
Dick Marting is among the many who've had to build back after Hurricane Ian. He lives just off the river in North Fort Myers. You can imagine how much water rushed in here.
Devastating. Really, you know, furniture floated and turned upside down, refrigerators floated and turned upside down, and it's, you know, it's a mess.
He and his wife lived in this trailer for more than a year after Ian. Repairing their home was a long process. So were the insurance claims.
It was slow, very slow. They didn't cover some things that we thought they should cover.
Not only that, since the storm, he says their flood insurance rate has nearly doubled.
We were disappointed, but we kind of anticipated it.
Marting, like the rest of us, is feeling the impact of Florida's home insurance crisis. Right now, a big part of fixing it has to do with the state-run Citizens Insurance.
It's really essential to have a stable insurance market in Florida, to have Citizens at a manageable risk level.
Insurance expert Mark Friedlander says that means moving policies from Citizens to private insurers. That's happened with more than 300,000 standard home policies since just October. Now, new legislation could help Citizens shave even more policies. It would allow surplus lines insurers to take out policies from Citizens on second homes. There are about 77,000 such policies in the state.
Secondary homes have been a big issue in Florida, because many of the standard home insurers have stopped writing that business.
Surplus lines insurers are not regulated the same way as standard insurers and don't have the same backstops that pay customers if a company goes under. But the legislation would require those insurers to have an A rating and be financially strong.
Going with a surplus lines carrier should not be a concern for a consumer because they're usually very highly rated, and the chances of them going insolvent are virtually zero.
As for Dick Marting, he already has sandbags stuffed ahead of the next storm season and a more permanent solution in the works.
Because of insurance and just for peace of mind, both, we're going to raise the house 6.5 feet once and for all, making sure this doesn't happen again. That's what we're trying to do.
Reporting local in North Fort Myers, I'm Evan Dean for NBC2.
According to state regulations, a surplus lines insurer could only take out policies from its Citizens if their price is within 20% of the Citizens premium renewal price. If it's more than that, a customer can opt to stay with Citizens.